Yes, that was a song out in the wilderness. Where to go when you are destined to go to the wilderness? Where to be when you are destined to be at home? Where to? Yes. What is up today? Today is a great day to wake up in the midst of the fog, the mist, in the mist of mind, in the fog of war. As they say, during this war in Gaza, you have the fog of war, or the smoke, or the dust of war, where everything is unclear, and it is this, let me do something here. It is the creativity, the fog, where everything is happening, you don't see. The fog of war is, or the fog of creation. It's in this mist of creation that God dwells. God is either this and either that, or nothing, but it is very, for us with pure eyes, if we can see, we just see a fog, a mist, where things is happening in a creative state, and where there are many people I've seen in on the markets of Kenya. We went to Kenya in 1965, and no talk about the football games. Then you have a lot of dust rising up to the heavens. But in the market, you had this cloud over the area where so many people were attracted to, gravitated to. In the heat of the day, when the sun is shining, you see the red carpet layer of soft layer of sand, of dust. When you are in the war, you see a lot of smoke, like in the recording of the war of Gaza. From a distance, you can see only fog. Either it's a cloud, or it's a big explosion that generate a cloud. It is the heat, the impact. So when God is appearing, it's this impact of His force that create dust, creates a mist. Let me Google that. The mist. We have to Google everything today in order to be in tune with letters. The mist. I think this, when you are in a complete chaotic state of mind, if you are really devastated to the core of your being, when so much have impacted you, so you don't even remember your name, your next duty, your next. give me a break. This is when the heat of the sun is burning you, when the turmoil is confusing you, you have an impact that you can't see clear. That's why I think it is most probably used in that context, that when it's so much clouded, so much heated tension, you need some recovery time. Time heals all wounds. I believe it more today than before. Because you see, if I have been into something that devastated me, I needed time to reorganize myself to what was happening. Also, I need time to get a distance from it. So not only am I in the cloud, the mist, the happening, the turmoil, I need a distance from that kind of situation. So when it's so impacting, it's not yet a black hole, but I think a black hole can be a portrait of the real impact that we are undergoing sometimes, because it creates a black hole, at least in me, when something of great importance is happening, or great impact, great turmoil. I need the time that elevates me so I can see the whole picture. So time, as I would say it, gives you a breaking moment of what is happening, what is really going on. I think that is important, that when you have experienced something very hard to take, the hard impact it had on you, you become kind of confused of what was really going on, where you attacked, where you defended, where you sabotaged, backstabbed or something. But if you give it time, your healing process, give time the benefit of the healing process. I think that is very important. See, sometimes we say, time is of the essence. Today I forgot everything. I even forgot my microphone. I don't know whether it was on or off, but after a time, I will know by recording, see the recording, and if the recording was okay or not.
But in that moment of mist, when the mist is there, the mist, in creation, you read about the mist that rose from the earth, that watered the plants. So mist is not a devastating impact. It is also nourishment. The mist from the ground, it proves that there are mist even in soil. The dough, let me Google that if I got it right. Dew. Let me put on some. You may sleep now, I don't know.
Dew.
The dew is in the soil, even in the desert. The dew is there to water the plants. The mist that falls in the evening after the sunshine, even how hot it have been, it becomes mist after the sun have gone down. The mist is appearing. It's quite odd that the sun dries out every stain of water. It evaporates, even though every day, even how hot it has been, it becomes mist, both in the evening and in the morning. So the mist is, as I have seen on different, maybe insects or some creatures that use their whole body in order to suck up this mist. They have so many intrinsic layers in their skin or skeleton that they can conserve the mist in a way that when it processed, it becomes water, so it falls down. So if you have a pot of water, heating water, it becomes mist. The heat makes it misty. So even during the day you can see the mist if you have these spectra glasses, but most commonly we don't, but we see in the blue sky, and that is too a proof of water. It is the light that reflects in the droplets of water. So even in the air, it's not without containing water. The air is part of the water. So it is created in a funny way. The water contains air. If not, you will sink straight through. And the air contains water, so you can have some nice fluid that you can both breathe without drowning. It is beneficial, but the nourishment that mist gives is when it's processed to water. It's kind of a rain that is created from the earth. So if it, back in those days it was not no rain. I don't know whether it was or not, but say it was no rain, even though the mist was watering the plants. Maybe in a better way, because it was harmonious. It was more up to the level of the harmony of nature. Maybe even today. So that the people doesn't dry out, the animals doesn't dry out. And we can see that the nourishment of the earth is still continuing. I said today that the Word of God is a blessing. It is encouraging. When you are in the heat of day, without any turmoil, there is no comfort. Let me there is no ointment. Ointment doesn't generate dust. It clears out the dust. The benefit of oil is that it cleans out the dust from the engine. It doesn't generate dust. It cools, and it drains out the dust. So the dust in the engine will fall down to the pan of the engine, where the oil is slinged out throughout the engine. So the ointment that God give is clearing your mind. And it's also said that the olive oil will make you remember. Because if you have this mist, you may probably forget, because as you know, he made water to wine, so you get a little bit foggy. you feel that you are on the top of the peak when the mist of your drinking is increasing. You are the top, you are not so devastated anymore, you are clear, ready to go, and all that kind of things that happens when you are drinking a little bit too much. But the oil, you don't need to drink so much oil. You take a sip and it will clear out your toxic waste. And olive oil will make you remember, clear out up your mind. I think that is very beneficial. So that after the mist, after the fog, after the dust have been seen in perspective, I think every human experience something like hardship. when people are cruel or revengeful. People revenge themselves because of this and because of that. They have some unfinished business. But in the end of the day, it's all their own turmoil. The fight they are fighting against certain people or revenge is obviously a fight against themselves. So when Jacob was trying to meet his brother Esau, he was fighting with an angel that needed to find himself. And after that, he was named Israel. I think that fight generated a clearance, it was fighting the whole night. And he won. Jacob fought with an angel and won. He was beating him. And I think he said, read it for you.
He struck the socket of his thigh, and the socket of Jacob's thigh was dislocated in his struggle with him. He said, "Release me, for dawn is broken." He said, "I will not release you, except if you bless me." He said to him, "What is your name?" He said, "Jacob." He said, "Jacob will not be said as your name anymore, but Israel, for you struggled with God and with men, and you are capable." He struck the socket of his thigh.
Sorry for that. In our Bible, in Norwegian, it is written that he fought with God and won. And Jacob said, "I don't release you." Yes, because it is the break of night. "Until you bless me." So Jacob was in this quite far. Because I think the whole time during his time with his father-in-law, Laban, was a time without the blessing of his father. Now he fought with God and he got the blessing in the day of dawn. So maybe Israel, your name is not Jacob. Your name is Israel, because you have fought with God and won. That is written in our Bible. And I remember that, and I will always believe that. the Savior of God. So, the mist. Maybe it was not a mist anymore for Jacob until the blessing, the heap, his heap was damaged, but he needed God's blessing. So in your life, in my life, we can feel damaged, but we don't give up. We encourage each other and we continue the good fight, even life can be hard. Even life can be hard, so hard that we almost give up. But that is the mist. That is the fog. The fog of war, as they say. Now, after all this turmoil have been part of your life, some losses, you have to count the losses too. But in the end, you realize what you really needed, what you really urged for. Maybe that was the realization of Jacob, that he needed God's blessing. He too, not only Abraham, Isaac, but also Jacob. Bless me. I think it is the one of the strongest words in the Bible. The fight of the war that Jacob was fighting, the real fight for his life, for his identity, for his true being. And some rabbis say that in every person on this earth, will, when they dig deep enough, they will find Jacob in themselves. The fight of life, the hardship of life, that you take everything seriously. You don't push around. Maybe you are indifferent to others, like Jacob was, that only wanted the blessing from his father. But in fact, he removed something from Esau. He was in the of the blessing. And I think that we can do so much, and we just generate dust in our life. We can strive so much, but it only generates dust, a cloud that is hard for other people to be together with, because when you are inhalating a lot of dust, it isn't nice. But we need the blessing. So the blessing is this kind of ointment that clears things out. When we talk, when I talk, it's a lot of confusion, maybe for you, maybe also for me. But in the end, we need to clear out some big topics, strongholds in that. So our life, we have to pray for a blessing in order to be a blessing for other people. If you just seek the blessing, you will not be a blessing at all, because it is just for you. But you can be the blessing. Raise me up. And if you can help people up, when you talk with people, say something nice. That is also true. Realize what people have that you are impressed by. Maybe you are not impressed, but you can say that you are so happy, that you are so nice, and a good friend, a dependent friend. And for me, everyone is a blessing. Either it's for that, or this or that. I don't know. In some way, when I let time work, it will be a blessing all the way. Even whatever happens, it will be a blessing. So, my friends, this is the blessing to you, the mist. And we say shalom. Bye-bye.